You always do vinyasa. So I'm sure you guys got that. Right. Yeah, cool. So we'll start at the top. Actually, let's start downward dog. Let's start downward dog. Good. So in downward dog, the hips are up and back. The heels here are disappearing behind your toes. It's not imperative that your heels touch the ground behind you. If they do, great. If they don't stress. Here you really want to work on your gaze being either at your toes or that space between your knees. And then you're drawing your chest toward your thighs just a little bit more. So think of flapping the back. Yeah, you guys have really good down back. And then the head sort of dangles between the upper arms. Good. So from here, you're going to take the right leg up and back. When you lift your right leg to the sky, you always want to have an internal rotation in that lifted hip. So turn your right toes towards the floor and find that internal rotation of the right hip. So instead of the toes out, you rotate it in. Good. Yeah, Chrissy, flex your toes towards the floor. Yes.
Yeah.
Beautiful. Whenever you're ready, take that lunge, right foot between your hands. Stay low here in your lunge. So in a low lunge, the hands always frame your front foot, so everything's in a line. Right knee is always 90. The big thing in yoga is it's all about alignment. So knee over ankle or hip over. So roll and stacking, essentially. Left hand is going to stay right inside your foot. So here comes that waterfall analogy. If you take the ball, you're holding it in that right hand, you're going to want to launch it toward that view on the wall. So you have to pull that right shoulder back just a little more in order to get that launch speed. Yeah, and then make sure you keep the foot fully flat on the floor. Yeah, really good. See if you can flex the back leg. Good. Last three. That's it. Two. Good. On one, take your right hand inside your foot. Good, you're gonna plop the back heel down. So here your heels are aligning. We're gonna wiggle up to warrior two. Yeah. It's like a little kung fu stuff. So the warrior two, right heel is always aligned with the back arch. Remember about the knee, you always wanna externally rotate the right thigh. And then here the shoulders drop. So oftentimes I always see this. Oh God. So the shoulders drop. I even sometimes tell people to feather it out. Yeah, just so you don't have that leg flow. And then whenever you're ready, flip your front thumb. Good. We're going to reverse that. Right arm up and over. We did this guy earlier. See if you can pivot the chest toward the sky. So I'll come by and sort of give you how that feels like. Right shoulder peels back just a little more. Good. Keep turning the shoulder upward. Yeah, that's it. Up. Yeah, upward. Yes. That's it. Last three. Good. Sink into your right knee. Remember, the knee tries to head toward the pinky toe. Good, yeah. Two. Good. So on one, we're going to standing splits. When you know your hands down to the floor, step up onto your right foot. Let the hands drop on your shoulders and the left leg lifts. So here the head gets to shake no and yes. So we'll break the pose down a little bit. Take your attention to your fingertips. They fall right under the shoulders. And then your right hip falls over the right knee, falls over the right. All the bones are stacked. Left leg is lifted. We're not really concerned with height here as much as we are with the internal rotation of the left hip. So the left hip peels in, left toes point to the floor. Yes, so flex your back ankle. Beautiful, this is your standing split. If you want to increase this, right, just a little bit more, walk your hands to either side of your right foot. And then see if you can peel the forehead a little closer towards your shin. This is one tenth. Yeah, that's it. Good. Breathe in three. Nice. Breathe in two. On one, drop your hands back out under the shoulders. Lift your chest, look between your hands. Here comes half moon. So in half moon, keeping the right fingers on the floor. Let them also know that they can use blocks under this hand just in case they want more elevation. First step, tendency for people here is to turn their knee in too much, turn it all the way out. So the next step from here, like level two or whatever, right foot comes to the calf, where it really presses in. Again, knee really opens up. Last step, right hand guides the foot into the inner thigh. And press the foot firmly into the inner thigh. You gotta flex this guy. A little rock for somebody to fall into. You'll hate them. And then again, you'll find that people want to keep going like this. Encourage them to really open it up. Right knee faces the right wall. From here with hands, I encourage people to get creative, but just from the beginning, you can start going up, get your palms to touch, and then crisscross your thumbs. Good. So if you're darker shoulders, a little bit more from your ears. Good. You can really find that balance of that left foot. This is really hard for a lot of people. You know, you guys eat, so this is no biggie. But the next tricky standing pose, you want to release the foot, take the right knee into your chest. Good. And then from here, you're going to take the hands to your heart. Kick the right leg back into warrior three. Flex your back foot. So toes, back foot toward the floor, internal rotation of the right hip.
Flexed.
Yeah, flex. Everything flexed.
Maybe it's all like
pointed. Oh, same here.
Yeah.
In yoga, I encourage people to put a micro bend in the left knee just for balance sake. Some people, if they walk out, it's uncomfortable, so maybe a slight bend here works. You can fly. You can take your own side. Good. Whenever you're ready, feet together. Forward fold. Very nice. Shake your head. No, yes. Good. From here, we're going to transition to the other side. So we'll take a pinata, inhale, circle the arms up. Sorry, some salute probably. Exhale, key out your arms, scoot your chest. Inhale, make the